Let's look at that right there. It is 9:09 p.m. on December the 18th, 2020, here in Salem, Indiana. Look at this. So, of course, we know that they don't got Pluto. They say Pluto's no longer a planet. But look at that, pointing to planet X, the suggested planet X orbit. Let me flip this around. I have been sitting on my laptop for the past, I don't know, 3 hours looking up stuff, just reading. Hello. Hello, wherever you are in any part of the world. Hello from my heart to yours. I've been sitting here reading about this planet X, how it's not supposed to exist, that it's supposed to be the ninth planet. Hello. Salam. Hello. Hola. Bom dia. Bonjour. Saludos. Ciao. Hello. Howdy. Alo. Tschüss. Oh, that's goodbye. Shalom. Hello. Welcome to Belgium. Hello. Oh, well, you're very welcome. I'm getting exhausted right now. Well, I don't think I look exhausted. Well, I probably am exhausted. My daughter is she's downstairs and she is, what is she doing? You know when you get a new wok, like these certain type of steel, like I don't know, kind of woks, and you have to condition them. Well, she has to condition this wok in the oven and put like some, I don't know, grease on it, and then bake it at 400 degrees for an hour, let it cool off, redo it. Oh, she's seasoning it, and I've got a towel down there at the door because I'm thinking I don't want to smell that from it can make its way upstairs, so I've been up here trying not to smell it. Hello. Hello, everyone. Yeah, but we're not talking about woks, seasoning woks. It's like seasoning cast iron skillets. We're talking about this right here, pointing to planet X. You know, this is what I found right here. Watch this. Look at this. Astronomers say a Neptune-sized planet lurks beyond Pluto. Do you all want to watch that? Because I want to watch that, but I got to make sure I've got this volume up so you all can hear it. I think I got the volume up because this is exciting. This is interesting because I just now stumbled upon this. And this is all for educational purposes only. This is what it is. Yes, we're going to watch it. Maybe I need to turn the lights out. We can be in a theater. We can pretend that like we're at the theater. That's what we can pretend. We're at the theater. But then I got to turn this light off up here. But let me see if I could get it or whatever. Nah, this is good. And I can't turn my phone like this, you all, because you know what it tells me? It says orientation is blocked. Please rotate your device back. So you all got to watch it like that. So let's hear what they have to say. I don't know how I got it to down there, but let's listen to it. Okay. No, I'm going to have to wait right there. I got to turn this off, this light up here. Hold on. I got to turn it off. We have got to watch this without the light on. Ooh, it's pretty dark. Oh my gosh, it's really dark now. I really feel like I'm in the theater. I really feel like I'm in a theater right now. Yeah, that's what I feel like. I feel like I'm in the theater. I turned the lights off, but you're gonna watch this movie together is what we're gonna do. Let's flip it around. You see it's dark? Let's watch this, you all.
Thousands of years ago, the skygazers of the classical world knew about six planets: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn. Thanks to the invention of the telescope, Uranus was discovered in 1781. But discrepancies in its orbit meant that something was tugging at it. Sure enough, that something turned out to be Neptune. Ever since, scientists have wondered if there might be yet another planet in our solar system, sometimes called Planet X. Now, astronomers have strong evidence for one, a planet roughly the size of Neptune, with a mass 10 times the Earth's and a thick atmosphere of hydrogen and helium. Just as Neptune was predicted based on its influence on Uranus, the evidence for Planet X is indirect. Astronomers observe six small solar system objects and notice they come closest to the Sun in a unique configuration. There's only a 1 in 15,000 chance that this orbital clustering is a coincidence. It is much more likely that Planet X has shepherded the six objects into their orbits. This explodes our conception of the solar system, because Planet X would loop around the Sun unimaginably far away in a strange elliptical orbit, so far away that it takes 15,000 years to make the trip. By comparison, Neptune's orbital period is 165 years. Of course, not everyone will be convinced of Planet X until we have visual proof. Researchers are now using one of the world's largest telescopes, Subaru, in Hawaii, and they say they have a reasonable chance of finding Planet X in the next 5 years. Once spotted, we can welcome Planet X as the ninth planet in our solar system.
All right, so we have seen that. Let me flip this around. We have seen that. So that was from 2016. That was from 2016. Planet X, that they are looking for Planet X. And you see that in 5 years, they said, they're pretty sure they can find it. Well, now it's going to be 2021. Okay, so now it's 2021. And I do apologize for not being able to turn my phone sideways. I've tried it. I've tried the landscape thing so many times, and it just does not work. So let's see what happened. Hello, Polly. Thanks for joining us. So I hope you all enjoyed that little movie. But you know what? And I also saw pictures of Pluto. Pluto and its moons. You know, they're talking about Pluto and its moons. This is back from, whoa, Gina, you really zoomed up on that. Look at this. They're talking about Pluto and its moons. New Horizons zoomed up on the sunset of Pluto, which is no longer a planet. And how can they get that close to Pluto? Okay, how can they? I've never heard of any photos of Pluto before. I really haven't. But that's what they did in 2015. Somebody on here earlier said that Pluto could have been Nibiru. That's what people said. Flowing ice on Pluto. Pluto's plains. I never seen nothing on Pluto ever before. Broken terrain on Pluto, but it's Pluto. Broken terrain on Pluto. Look at that. They got this images of Pluto. Now, if NASA can get images like that, they can get images of all those ships that are flying around. Look at that. Range of surface fractures on Pluto. Pluto's moon, Charon. Look at that. Pluto had a big moon. Okay, so let's look at this. Halos on Pluto. Look at that. This is supposed to be Pluto. And I don't know. Why is Pluto red? And they decided to kill Pluto off. Here's Pluto with all of its little moon. There's its moon and everything else around it. And then Pluto is, it's red. Target Pluto. That's pretty interesting about Pluto. So let me flip this around. And we're not talking about Pluto. We're supposed to be talking about this ninth planet that these scientists have said a Neptune-sized planet lurks beyond Pluto, the ninth planet for the solar system. And they're going to call that the Planet X. That's what they're calling it, Planet X. Let's see. Watch something. This is all interesting. It really is. I did read something about, what did I read about? Oh, this is pretty cool looking. Look at this. Flip this around right there. Boom. Look at that. I don't know what that is. Oh, that's Pluto's largest moon, Charon. Does that look like it's, I don't know what that is, but I don't mean to get off of here. But I want to talk about this. Look at this. Last year, the dust storm. This is what I really wanted to talk about, the dust storm. Last year, the dust storm was a record-breaker African dust that hit. during the COVID. It was a record breaker dust. They've said since 1970, the dust storms from the Sahara are getting worse and worse and worse. And the algae bloom, whatever that red tide is getting worse and worse, and it's killing the fish. It's killing the fish. It's suffocating. They're dying of oxygen and all of that. Oh, somebody, Richard, somebody, did somebody get rid of a Richard? Yeah. That's great. Let's look at that. Oh my goodness. Ah, Gina. But listen, this dust storm. I read something else about it. Richard, bye. That's right. Yeah, if Richard needed to go bye, he's out the door. I shouldn't laugh, and you have the comments kind of funny. So they said that a dust storm was the worst. It really was. Oh my gosh. They said it was known as a giant. Look at this. They said that this was known as a latest biblical plague, a terrifying Sahara dust storm, a giant Sahara dust storm. Okay, that's what it was. The giant Sahara, it was the Godzilla of the dust storms. Okay, and this dust storm, I heard this climatologist or something, she said that it was the worst, it was the thickest last year. It was the thickest that she's ever seen it in the past 17 years of keeping records. And they explain it. The dust was thicker, okay? It was thicker than the year before. And what I want to get to is, well, here it was right here. I guess it was a climatologist for the, it's bad for your health. Is what it was. Okay, her 16 years. Look at this. Get down from there. This says the massive dust cloud that arrived in Puerto Rico the Sunday before last, sweeping in and staining. It stained the evening sky a milky white. Well, we see milky white all the time. Monday and Tuesday, the air grew heavier with dust by the hour. Late Tuesday, Olga Malabracho, Mayol Becerro, an atmospheric chemist at the University of Puerto Rico, Rio Piedras, checked the readings of the atmospheric observation station she runs on the northeastern tip of the island. The numbers were higher than anything that she had seen in the 16 years that she had been taking measurements at that station. The highest in 16 years. So it is getting thicker. Okay, and we're having increase in fireballs, too. Green fireballs. Yeah. Oh, is that where it's at? Yeah, green fireballs. But I read something that's really interesting about the arrival of Nibiru and the red dust. It says that the tail of Nibiru is comprised of red dust, charged particles of iron oxide, and that is what is in this Sahara dust that is coming around every single year. And last year, it was the thickest that it's ever been. Okay, and this, look at this. So this makes the water turned blood red, and it makes it very bitter. The water is bitter that the iron dust gets into. Yes, that's what it does. The iron dust that gets into it. There was something else I read about on here. Let me find this, because this is really interesting. Since its tail, and it don't just have red dust. There's been, like, as they say, there's a heavy dusting that will occur with this Nibiru tail, but this will precede the pole shift by hours. And it's not the little fine dust that we're seeing right now, but the dust is getting thicker. You got this fine red dust that gets all over everything. Like in Russia, one time, it rained pink snow. that is not from the Sahara Desert. It's from that tale of Nibiru with the iron oxide, the fine red dust. And it's very dangerous to your health to breathe it in. It really is. But they say the tail, after you have this fine red dust, and then when the dust gets heavier and heavier, then you're in trouble, and then the pole shift can come. And then you're going to have these fireballs and meteorites and stuff happen. They say that as this planet gets closer to the sun, it like stops. It just slows down and just stops, but the tail keeps going. That's what it is. So you'll see very, very heavy dusting of this red dust is what it said. It's red dust, charged particles of iron oxide, and it affects the waters. It gives them a bitter taste is what it does. The red sand dunes from the iron oxide. Yeah, so there's lots of, I'm not a geologist and I'm not a chemist with the type of minerals and stuff that is contained in the atmospheric clouds of the deserts. I'm not, but there is iron oxide, and this red tide is increasing, and the sandstorms are getting worse with each passing year, and they're getting thicker. They are getting thicker, making the atmosphere thicker. We get these beautiful sunsets and sunrises, but beautiful reddish sunsets. And one day it's going to make the earth, the poles are going to flip. And we can have our large earthquakes. But yeah, there's stuff going on, you all. But to have these astronomers saying the new ninth planet for the solar system. Yeah. The planet X, which this morning, you know, they've been talking about it, is what they've had. It will rain 7 days. And yeah, you know what they said? I think they said it takes around 6.5 days or something, maybe, for it to make its way around its elliptical orbit or something. Something like that. I don't know. Exactly. I'm just now reading in that stuff because I don't study it. I really don't, but I think it's all interesting. And it's interesting that they were looking for that ninth planet. And the claim is the strongest yet in the centuries long search for planet X beyond Neptune. So they've been looking for it, is what they've been looking for it. And they have found it. They said it's going to be thrilling because it's going to be detectable. And that's what you've got. You've got these scientists. Let me flip this right here. These scientists, they're so happy. They are so happy to find that ninth planet beyond Neptune. And it's very large. But you're not hearing nothing about it, the discovery. Planet X is out there. Astronomers ought to find out more objects in the telltale orbit shaped by the pull of the hidden giant. It's a hidden giant, is what they said. A hidden giant. It's in Hawaii. They want to use the team has time on one large telescope in Hawaii. Hawaii. Killing Pluto is fun, but this is the head and shoulders above everything else. Planet X is the head and shoulders above everything else. So, yeah, that's about it. That's about all I've got to say about it. Yeah. Oh, well, you're very welcome. And I'm not one who studies this, but I find it kind of interesting. I can share whatever. If I find an article or something like that, you all can see it. I'll share it with you. I don't know. Yeah, and it's best to keep it on layman's terms. It's best to look at things like me and like you, like ordinary people. We don't need a big-time, over-the-head, scientific explanation. Sometimes it's good. It really is, but it's okay. It is all right. Yeah. The Vatican has a sculpture of this thing. Really? Yeah. You're also very welcome. You're so very, very welcome. But I think this Sahara Dust right here, right there, I think this is part of it. And they urge you to stay in, and you need to have a mask on because you don't want to be outside with this dust. I remember it. It was so thick and hazy, but it's not something different. And it comes around in June. It starts, and the meteors are coming, and the fireballs, green streaks of meteors and stuff. Good evening. Yes. Is Bill Gates selling off his assets too? Really? Yeah. I don't live in fear because really there's nothing. Fear is not in my future. It's not in my destiny. It's not in my, it's not on my timeline. It's not a part of me. It can't be. And it shouldn't be a part of you too. You've got to keep going. You do. Oh, wow. Boom. Yeah. Well, you all, I am going to go. Thank you all for tuning on, coming on here. And I'm not claiming to be any expert or nothing. I just wanted to share with you, this was a pretty cool video with them talking about this ninth planet.
That it takes 15,000 years to make the trip.
Look at that.
By comparison, Neptune's orbital period is 165 years. Of course, not everyone will be convinced of Planet X until we have visual proof.
Planet X.
Earth, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn. Thanks to the invention of the telescope, Uranus was discovered in 1781. But discrepancies in its orbit meant that something was tugging at it. Sure enough, that something turned out to be Neptune. Ever since, scientists have wondered if there might be yet another planet in our solar system, sometimes called Planet X. Now, astronomers have strong evidence for one. A planet roughly the size of Neptune, with a mass 10 times the Earth's, and a thick atmosphere of hydrogen and helium. Just as Neptune was predicted based on its influence on Uranus, the evidence for Planet X is indirect. Astronomers observe 6 small solar system objects and notice they come closest to the Sun in a unique configuration. There's only a 1 in 15,000 chance that this orbital clustering is a coincidence. It is much more likely that Planet X has shepherded the 6 objects into their orbits. This explodes our conception of the solar system because Planet X would loop around the Sun unimaginably far away in a strange elliptical orbit, so far away that it takes 15,000 years to make the trip. By comparison, Neptune's orbital period is 165 years. Of course, not everyone will be convinced of Planet X until we have visual proof. Researchers are now using one of the world's largest telescopes, Subaru, in Hawaii, and they say they have a reasonable chance of finding Planet X in the next 5 years. Once spotted, we can welcome Planet X as the ninth planet in our solar system.